The Fractal Meshify 2C is, well, it might not be the best computer case, but it's easily top three for sure. And if building in it is easy today, then like top one or two probably. It's freaking sweet, it looks awesome, and it should keep your components cool. What's there not to like? Come on. Meshify 2 Compact User's Guide. Yeah, that's a fine looking PC right there. One of the big things over the last one was before, in order to like get at the dust filter in here, it was a terrible time. Now what you do is just pull on that logo right there and boom, dust filter. This comes off. You just pull it a bit and boom. Okay, very easy access to the dust filter. Okay, the top filter is not magnetic, which I actually like. I find those always get kind of like misplaced. And I believe it's totally toolless. Ooh, yeah. So that just comes right off. Let's put that back on for now. Rear, I think, is also toolless. Oh, this is gonna be so easy here today. I really like this design in the front. For I/O, you get two USB 3, headphone, microphone, and new for this one is the Type-C up here as well. Moving around, yeah, it's a computer case. there you go. Let's start building. I wanna do it. I've selected components that are, according to the side of the box, will fit, but very close to not fitting. I believe you can take off the top as well. Yes. This just, heck yeah. This is going to be such an easy build. Accessories, it's all look pretty standard. If you look on the bottom here as well, filter, you just pull from the front, bring it out like that, super easy to clean. I am going to remove the hard drive trays just to get the PSU in, and then we'll have to put them back on. Well, there's our first kind of stupid thing. The foot interferes with where the hard drive tray's screw is. Just come out. Okay, we'll just move it up as far as we can go for now. This also has the power supply removable thing, which makes getting your power supply in so much easier. Today we're going with the Seasonic Prime TX1000. I don't have any good reason besides this is a really sick power supply. That's kind of the long and short of it right there. And it smells good too. Now this power supply should just go in. Doing it this way makes your life so much easier than trying to like get all of the cables in afterwards once it's inside. I do really like that they already have some straps here for your CPU power. So today for a CPU, we're going with a 10900K. It's hot, but most importantly, it was at my desk and I already had built this computer, so we don't have to worry about it not working or anything. I also have two sticks of RAM for 16 gigabytes in total, and there's already an SSD in here. I think it's a 970 Evo. Oh, this is so nice with the top gone. Now, I did make what could have been quite a bad mistake right there because I totally forgot to add in the cooler mounting, but this case does have the big old hole in the back, so I'll be able to access that when the time comes in a couple minutes. Building PCs is so easy now. Yeah, back in my day, you had to get a bunch of cuts from the unfinished edges on your steel case. It should be noted that they give you exactly how many screws you need to attach the motherboard and the power supply, so don't drop them on the floor. You guys get a bit of a bonus here on Short Circuit today, two unboxings in one. This is the Arctic Liquid Freezer 2 280. And as far as I can tell, it's pretty freaking sweet. According to Gamers Nexus, the performance on this thing's really good. But at the same time, Arctic's performance has been quite good for a while now. My concern is more so just the mounting. Oh, geez, she's a bit big. Well, this is gonna be fun. One silly thing about this is they have a little fan up here that's supposed to cool down your VRMs. I feel like it's not gonna be useful for almost everyone. Aside from that, I think it looks pretty cool. Scooch of MX4 here. Will I still have easy, Okay, if you're building in this case, you should not install your AIO before you put power to everything. I would do that last. For a GPU, we're going to be using the Aorus RTX Extreme 10 gigabyte. It's a 3080 and it is freaking huge. I think we have just a couple millimeters of clearance. Nice, no problems there. Oh geez, this is a very big cooler for this. But it should be fine. So this is where taking the top out is pretty fantastic, because now we can drop this down in here. Oh, maybe. It does say up to 240 on the top.
Are those 280s?
This is a 280. Okay. Doesn't fit, not even close. So long, Arctic. You sent us a cooler, and that actually was really easy to put in, but the one that you sent us is too big. All right, moving on to my favorite cooler in the world, the NHD15. It's big, it looks sick, it cools your stuff really well. No complaints, it's what I use in my personal rig. Again, I know I've said this like 10 times, but this would be terrible if the top was still on. Oh, do you think that I can get in the fan for the CPU cooler without removing the GPU? It is right up against the cooler. I'm going to use this hook. It's in the iFixit kit. Maybe. Hell yeah, did it. Wow, we almost have a computer. So let's get the cables in here. Da-da-da. Oh man, we just got so lucky. So on a lot of motherboards, it is possible that the USB headers will be down under where the graphics card is right now, and I totally forgot to connect them. But on this one, they're just up here above the GPU, so we're good. Now, it does seem like there's no fan hub included with this. The original one, I think, only had one 120 millimeter fan up in the front. This one, you get the two 140s and also a 120 in the back. So that's way more cooling for your components out of the box. Like, when you're buying a case in this price range, this one's $110, the old one was 90. You're probably not going to want to spend like 50 bucks on sick Noctua fans. So it's really nice that they have these pretty good ones here stock. For storage, I'm going with a 12 terabyte Seagate Exynos. It's overkill for pretty much anything. The only reason that I have it is because it just arrived in the office and it's the first hard drive that I saw when I went looking for them. We've got the cage here. Is it only one screw? Nice. And then this, I believe, just goes right on like that. Hard drive just slides right back in there like that. That was very easy. Now we do want to reattach the hard drive cage. I feel like kind of no matter what, you want to move it as far forward as you can, just to give yourself more space for all of the cables. Hey, Jono, how much effort should we put into cleaning up the back of this case?
Zero.
Zero? What about you put on a timer for 2.5 minutes? And whatever we can achieve in that amount of time is how good the back's gonna be. Timer for 2.5 minutes. Speed cable management, yeah. These straps are not as good as I originally thought because you can't really tighten them down, but at the same time, way better than no straps at all. Oh, balls. All right, screw it, we're just bundling it. Minute 30, oh, balls. It's cramming time now.
Four, 3, 2, 1.
For 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I think that's a really clean backside of your case. Now, the one big thing that you don't get with this case is RGB. There's basically, yeah, there's none. There's just no RGB at all. You can put the top back on now. Back panel. This, I think, came off the bottom. Yep. Are we done? I think we're done. Hour and a half? Not too bad, especially given that we probably could have saved nearly half an hour if we didn't bother with the air cooler there. That was, especially for the size of this case, an exceptionally easy little PC build. I don't know about you guys, but I think that this is a fantastic looking rig. I really like this case. Its biggest competitor is easily the O11 Dynamic Mini, but the reason why I'm more inclined to recommend this one is because this takes a full ATX power supply. The O11 Mini, you have to use an SFXL, so that gets really expensive really fast if you're trying to put like 1,000 watt or like anything above 600 watts in it. Heck yeah. Well, there we go. The Meshify 2 Compact is a freaking awesome little case. And I think if you're looking for a case and, like, you know, about $110, you really can't go wrong with this thing. Hit like, get subscribed, have a great old day. See ya.